Hi, my name is Craig Walker. I'm the Assistant Chief of the Utah Division of Wildlife Resources Aquatics Section. Today, I'm going to provide you with an update on our assessment of division efforts to manage the availability of desired fishing opportunities to meet angler needs. Our presentation will focus on two broad topics. First, I'll provide you with an outline of the various ways the division is working to tailor fishing opportunities to meet the needs of anglers. I will then provide you with an update on our exploration of whether limited entry fishing opportunities are a good fit for Utah at this time. So what is the division doing to tailor Utah's fishing opportunities to the needs of anglers? Well, as you just saw, we are modifying regulations. Additionally, we are assessing what anglers want. Further, we are taking a look at what fishing experiences we currently offer by inventorying our fisheries and our stocking efforts. And we are changing the way we manage the public's fisheries. As Randy just showcased throughout his presentation, the division's suggested regulation changes are designed to address the needs of anglers by providing diverse fishing opportunities sought by anglers, accomplishing division management objectives, and simplifying regulatory language to increase angler understanding and establish regulatory consistency where possible. As I mentioned, one reason for modifying regulations is to provide anglers with what they want. That begs the question, how does the division find out what anglers want? Well, first, we continue to build on the insights presented to the RACS and Wildlife Board in 2019, examining data related to angler preferences for species, fishing gears, access methods, and settings. And we continue to identify additional questions that we need to ask during the 2021 statewide angler survey in order to collect the data we need to gain further insight. In 2019 and 2020, a large portion of the division's efforts to assess angler needs was focused on contrasting people's fishing preferences with what fishing experiences we really offered. Based upon these efforts, we determined that 80% of anglers in the state of Utah prefer to fish for trout and salmon, while 20% of anglers prefer to fish for other species. However, when we look at what fish are stocked in Utah, 94% of stocked fish are actually trout and salmon, while only 6% of stocked fish are other species. At first blush, it looks like the division is stocking more trout and salmon and fewer warm water fish than is required to meet the needs of anglers. When we look at a county scale, stocking efforts are generally in line with the number of resident anglers and number of angler days spent in 79% of Utah's counties. However, stocking of trout and salmon exceeds needs in Carbon, Grand, Millard, Paiute, Rich, and Weber counties. Additionally, stocking of other species does not meet angler needs in Grand, Millard, Morgan, Paiute, Rich, and Wayne counties. Although this county level assessment points to gaps between the fish the division provides and the fish that anglers desire, there are additional questions that need to be answered prior to modifying how stocked fish are allocated to fisheries in Utah in an attempt to address angler needs. What does the water-specific angler pressure look like? What does harvest of fish look like at these waters in question? Does a lack of suitable habitat prevent the stocking of some species in certain areas? Broadly, are the apparent gaps accounted for by these factors, and can changes actually be made? As we begin to take stock of the fishing opportunities in Utah, the scope of what is undertaken annually by division personnel becomes clearer. Every year, division personnel stock an average of 94 rivers, an average of 497 reservoirs with trout and salmon, an average of 64 reservoirs with other species, on average 7.8 million trout and salmon, and 475,000 warm water fish over 2 inches in length are stocked annually in Utah waters. Additionally, the division purchases and stocks 590,000 warm water fish every year. Based on the inventories we've undertaken to date, the Division of Wildlife Resources appears to be doing the things necessary to meet angler needs in Utah and provide satisfying fishing experiences. However, we must always be willing to adapt our management strategies to ensure that we are able to maintain angler satisfaction in the face of change and address the challenges ahead. As I mentioned last year, one of the challenges that we are going to face in the coming years is a growing number of licensed anglers. Currently, there are 377,000 licensed resident anglers in the state of Utah. By 2035, this number is projected to increase to 450,000 anglers. This increase assumes that we will maintain the stable 20% angling participation rate we have seen since 2010. However, during the recent pandemic, participation in angling appears to be increasing. Whether this increased participation will persist is unknown. What is known is that aquatics managers must be ready to address ever-increasing needs of a growing angler population. How will the division meet the needs of a growing angler population and prevent anglers from outstripping our capacity to manage effectively? We're going to be doing this in several ways. We will continue to engage in the adaptive strategic approaches that we have undertaken in recent years, following the guidance outlined in the Aquatic Section Strategic Plan to foster greater coordination and cooperation. We will build on recent efforts that have resulted in the creation of 17 fisheries management plans, a community fisheries plan, a statewide stocking strategy, a tiger muskie management plan, and a hatchery development and culture plan. We will continue to explore the use of new approaches, tracking angler returns of tagged fish, gathering and providing fishing information using our new web application, and using sterile predators to control unwanted fish populations, provide trophy opportunities, and protect adjacent native fish populations. We will continue to increase the capacity of our hatchery system to produce more warm water fish. And as I mentioned earlier, we will continue to critically evaluate the allocation of those fish to meet growing angler needs. Finally, we will continue to create new fishing opportunities by increasing species diversity, improving shoreline access, building new community fisheries, and increasing the size of the trout we stock in some waters to meet management needs. I'd like to switch gears a little and talk about a type of fishing opportunity that the Wildlife Board has asked us to investigate, limited entry fishing. As I mentioned, the limited entry fishing concept was something that the Wildlife Board asked us to investigate after last year's informational presentation. This year, we learned that Oregon is investigating allowing limited entry fishing opportunities at some fisheries where anglers have been historically barred from fishing. Oregon will be assessing the effectiveness of these efforts in 2023 and providing the division with their thoughts at that time regarding angler as well as agency costs and benefits. Right now, the Division of Wildlife Resources is waiting for their assessment before contemplating any moves here in Utah. We will continue to keep our eyes open while we wait, looking for opportunities that might lend themselves well to this concept. However, before any limited entry opportunity is pursued in the state, several questions must be answered. Will there be potential impacts to local users if access to a water is limited to only permittees? Will limiting fishing opportunities jeopardize partners? Is the opportunity in question limited in supply or availability, for example, trophy species? Would limited entry opportunities address division management and conservation needs? Will this effort impact local businesses, guides, outfitters? Generally speaking, would the benefits of offering limited entry opportunities to a few anglers in Utah outweigh the potential costs to hundreds of thousands of anglers across the state? Until we answer that question, the efficacy of limited entry opportunities for fishing in Utah remains unknown. With that, I'd like to thank you for your time and let you know that any comments you might have can be submitted by using the link below. Thank you.